Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see the details on Apache Sling Repo Init. Most of the time, the initial setup of the AEM repository is time-consuming and challenging. Example, setting up the service users, user groups, ACLs for the nodes, base content and configurations. Also, keeping all the environments synced with the required basic configuration is another challenge. Some of the issues like enabling service users across different environments are managed through custom ACS Commons solutions like ACS Commons Ensure Service User. This will help to define the service user through code. The repo init helps to manage this through out-of-the-box solution. The repo init provides instructions or scripts that define JCR structures ranging from common node structures like folder trees to users, service users, groups and ACL definition. The key benefits of repo init are they have implicit permissions to perform all actions defined by their scripts and invoked early in the deployment lifecycle, ensuring all required JCR structures exist by the time code is executed. Also, all the repository related configurations are managed through code. Some of the scenarios the repo init is very useful are creating groups, creating users, then assigning permissions, creating required paths, then setting properties to the nodes, assigning group membership, then even we can create service user. Also, if required, we can register custom namespace. The users and groups required to the functioning of the application should be defined through repo init. The organization users and groups should still be defined at runtime through AEM. The repo init repository initialization language helps us to define the repo init script. As discussed, this supports various scripts. Example, create service user, you can specify the username, then setting ACL on specific paths, lips, apps, then allow, deny, what permission, JCR read, JCR write. Then again, creating a specific path, then we can specify the folder type here. Then setting ACL based on the users. So here we are specifying based on the user, then specifying the path here, what path we are allowing and denying. Then even we can register custom namespace. Even we can create users, groups, then assign or remove users from group. Also set properties on specific nodes. Any properties you can set on a specific node. Refer this URL to get more details on repo init language. You can find sample scripts to handle different scenarios. Create service user, set ACL. We discussed already. So even you can refer here for different samples. The repo init scripts are defined in ui.config project. A script for the latest archetype. Repo init scripts are stored as script entries of repository initializer OSJ factory configuration. So it can be targeted for specific run modes to define run mode specific repo init configurations. Here I am enabling the configuration only for author run mode. This is the sample configuration for author run mode. OSJ config, config.author, then the PID, repository initializer, demo.config.cfg.json. Then these are all the sample scripts, creating a service user, then setting ACL on var my data for this specific user created in this script, then creating a path /conf my app settings with the node type sling folder. These scripts are executed early in the deployment process so that all the required configurations /content exists in the system before the actual code is executed. This is the content of the configuration file. Individual scripts are comma separated. Then individual lines are, the new lines are delimited with the new line delimiter. So let me quickly modify and deploy this. Maybe I will go with the service one. Then maybe my data one, then same thing here. Yeah, maybe app settings. Maybe I will save app one. Yeah. Let me quickly save this, go to deployment. The deployment is success now. Let us see the configurations enabled through repo init. Let me go into here. I am going to this user console. Then let me type my data. Yeah, I have this my data reader service one. So the service user is defined. If you see here, the permission also defined, like var my data one, JCR read allow. Now let me go to the CRXT. Then if I go to conf folder, let me refresh that. Yeah, here I can see my app one. The same thing, if I go to where, then refresh the where. Yeah, I can see the my data one, the folder. Let us see the script configurations through OSJ console. So let me go here. So then let me search for repo init. Yeah, so if you can see here Apache Sling repository initializer factory, we have one configuration and then open that. Yeah, you can see the scripts, individual scripts here, because it was comma separated. So here it's defined as a individual script. Create service user, then create path, then set ACL, then we have one more create path. The repo init scripts must be defined in the inline script section, and the reference configuration will not work currently in AEM. AEM is not using the latest repo init bundles. Let me show that. If I go here, bundles, repo init, yeah, it's using 1.1.28, but if you go to the Maven repository, 1.1.26 is the latest version. I am running this demo with latest AEMS Cloud Server SDK in local, but the same can be executed with AEM 6.5 SP4 plus versions. Repo init is a useful feature to enable the initial configurations that will help us to initiate the repositories quickly and also helps to keep the AEM instance in sync for the initial configurations. Help to reduce the initial repository setup timeline, also manage the repository configurations through code. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.